Body-on-frame vehicles used to be the standard for cars and trucks, and while trucks still tend to use this design, most family vehicles like coupes, crossovers, minivans, and sedans are all unibody now. I'll explain why this change has occurred, but first, what even is body-on-frame or unibody? Let's start with body-on-frame, since that's generally regarded as the first design, which was carried over from horse-drawn buggies. This design starts with a frame chassis, which a body can be mounted to. A manufacturer can use a single frame design as the basis for multiple vehicles, such as a pickup truck using the same frame as a van. This modular design allows for repairs to be made with the body removed, or even a full frame replacement if necessary. Because the body, the part people are in, is isolated from the chassis, this can also reduce noise, vibration, and harshness. This means a more comfortable ride, all other things being equal when compared to a unibody design. That same disconnect can also lead to a less precise feeling steering, additional perceived body roll, and is usually the biggest contributor to that truck-like feeling. The unibody design is quite old, but the metallurgy technology that could really take advantage of it came in time for the design to really gain popularity in the 1980s. The unibody mostly eliminates separate chassis parts and integrates a lot of the solid structure into the body. Most unibody vehicles still have an engine cradle that supports suspension components, but the top and bottom of the body are all one unit resisting flex as various forces are applied. The natural rigidity of a unibody design means less reinforcement is required to achieve the same result, making a lighter overall vehicle. So many modern vehicles use the unibody design because it has important advantages for both the manufacturer and the owner. Their added rigidity improves handling characteristics, their lighter weight improves fuel efficiency, acceleration, braking, and handling. Since less material is used, there is a cost savings to be found there, for the vehicle manufacturer, the person purchasing the vehicle, or both. So, let's answer some common questions about these designs. If unibody is so much better, why isn't everyone using it for every vehicle? Part of this comes down to what a car manufacturer can do with one chassis, like what was mentioned earlier with the example of the truck and the van using the same chassis. However, it's what's done after the vehicle leaves the factory that is even more important. You may have noticed there are work trucks that look like a pickup truck, but instead of the traditional bed, they have a tool storage unit or service body. The service body most likely wasn't produced by the company that built the chassis, engine, and cab. It can be, but a lot of these are custom built for particular jobs, like food trucks or ambulances. In short, the body-on-frame design makes customization easy. However, it's not impossible to heavily modify a unibody vehicle. Many stretch limousines are examples of unibody vehicles that have been cut apart and welded back together in a customized way. Why are body-on-frame vehicles favored for off-road applications? While modern unibody designs may be sturdy enough to handle moderate off-road flex, older designs sometimes encountered bent body issues that could prevent doors from functioning properly or even opening at all. The bushings that isolate the body from the chassis keep the body safe from moderate chassis flex if it occurs. Are there designs other than body-on-frame and unibody? There have been other designs through history, but these two have remained the popular two because they don't have any glaringly difficult trade-offs like cost or shape limitations. Monocoque chassis are the closest to being found in everyday vehicles, having been developed for motorsports and used in some high-performance road vehicles. Many larger race cars use tube frame chassis, which is incredibly strong, but also expensive and limits the amount of space available for the driver and passengers. There's also the platform chassis, famously used by the classic Volkswagen Beetle, which is similar to body-on-frame except the chassis has more to it. Things like the transmission tunnel, floor pans, and in modern electric vehicles, flat battery storage. A skateboard chassis is quite similar, but more focused on being a self-contained platform that allows different bodies to be designed for the same chassis without changing a lot of fundamental parts. I know there's more out there, but I'm going to leave that up to the comment section. So as we move on to the next question, let me know what chassis designs I missed. Are there any trucks that are unibody, and what were the last smaller cars to be made with body-on-frame? The first unibody pickup truck was the short run of Ford's integrated pickup design, starting with the 1961 F-100. However, this is not a unibody as what has been described today. What was special about this truck was that the cab and bed had one unbroken panel, which saved on production costs. On most pickup trucks even today, the bed is separate from the cab and can be removed on its own. Not the case with with this truck, but the cab and bed as one body unit still sat on a separate frame. True unibody pickups do exist, like the 2006 Honda Ridgeline and the 2022 Ford Maverick, both of which are controversial vehicles among truck enthusiasts by being unibody trucks. The last car to be produced with a body on frame was the 2012 Ford Crown Victoria, a full-size family sedan with a V8 and rear-wheel drive. These were very well known for their role as police cars during their production years and beyond, which probably played a role in their continued use of the body on frame design. I think that's all I can squeeze out of that topic, but if you have any questions, be sure to leave them in the comments section. I'll try to get to them all, but I do have comments in over 300 videos at this point, so it's hard to get to them all. Speaking of which, consider subscribing. I regularly make automotive content, and if you made it all the way to the end of this video, you probably enjoy learning about cars. So thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in the next Car Simplified video.